Robbie Weeds here. Wanted to talk a little more about Dallisgrass. This is a smooth Dallisgrass ID'd as the round seeds on one side of the seed head. You can see how it's growing nice and flat. The center is starting to die out as when Dallisgrass matures. It's a bunch type grass, so it doesn't spread by rhizomes, but what it does do is the bunch gets so big that it strangles the center of itself and creates space in there, and another type of grass or weed will then fill that spot, and that's how Dallisgrass ends up looking separated, or as if it's growing by rhizomes or stolons, but really just a bunch type grass that grows so closely together it strangles itself, creates space. Like I said, this is smooth Dallisgrass, smooth paspalum, I should say. There's a bunch of different paspalums, and I've shown a couple my other videos that inhibit Southeast Pennsylvania where I work. But a management strategy that I've started to work with recently is using mesotrione tenacity, doing two or possibly three applications. And from what I've read from clinical studies, is that it will get at least as good of control as MSMA. So that's good to know, because when you're using MSMA and people look it up, they see that it's based on arsenic. They don't like hearing, you know, people are very cautious about any chemical, and then they see arsenic being sprayed on their lawns, even though it's a formulation of arsenic that's not terribly toxic, and it doesn't leach really at all. There's a ton of other chemicals that we use that are worse than MSMA. You know, diquat or paraquat comes to mind, but yeah, it's nice to hear that there are selective options other than MSMA and Pilex to treat Dallisgrass, because people don't like hearing that there's this really ugly, really horrible textured grass in their yard that's one, perennial, and two, can't be treated selectively. When you tell them get out there with Roundup, that's the last thing they want to hear, or dig it up. You know, they want it magically to be gone just like a dandelion. So I've been looking more into using tenacity, and I have a couple projects out that I've sprayed once already, and I'm going to follow it up with a second application. That's the one bad thing about tenacity is it does have pre-emergent control and post-emergent control and a ton of different weeds, but you need to do the second application. If you don't do the second application, you'll blight it out, it'll turn white, but it will always come back, almost everything. So, you know, I'll get back out there in 10 to 14 days with a second application of tenacity and see what happens. But it's very promising that it's not labeled. Now, that is the thing. Tenacity is not labeled for Dallisgrass, so it is off-label use. And as turf grass professionals and IPM professionals, there's a ton of times when we use chemicals off-label. So, there's a million reasons. And sometimes labels are different state to state. Using things off-label isn't the maybe correct way to do it, but it's pretty common in the industry to, if you do have a way to get around it and, you know, get something done, especially with a chemical like tenacity, that you're not doing any harm by using it or using it any differently. It's just you're widening the spectrum of control. So yeah, hopefully I'll show some results with tenacity and we'll get some Dallisgrass death, and we could start out here selectively killing a whole bunch of Dallisgrass and getting it out of here and stop it invading beautiful lawns. Robbie Weeds out.